What's up, everyone? It's DV, and today I'm beginning a new journey through hardcore mode in Roblox Islands. So if you've been bored or down about the economy in this game, well, I invite you to join me in this journey. I think we're gonna have a lot of fun. So what is hardcore mode, you might ask? Well, it's pretty simple. So it's a mode that my friend JCTC came up with when he was over the broken economy as well, because, you know, again, it's not the dev's fault, it's the dupers. The dupers are making millions and millions of copies of items, and it's really ruining prices of things and value of things, and it's just, the game's all over the place. You can basically become rich within minutes in this game. So the only reason why you can become rich very quickly was because of dupes, and the game really turned into a marketplace. So pretty much the goal of everyone in this game these days is just to become rich by buying and selling. So it's kind of become like a pawn shop game. So you pretty much, you know, buy low, you sell high. So that's not really hooked me into the game, you know, and that's not really why I play the game. So I decided to go ahead and do a similar challenge to what Jesse did. So if you want to check those videos out by Jesse, definitely check his channel in the description below so you can check out his hardcore series. So the great thing about this mode is that dupers can't really impact anything when you play in this method. So it really breathes the new life in the game, and I get to experience the game that the developers have made, right? So, you know, and the game's really positioned to be a lot like Minecraft, whether we want it to be unique or not. And they've done a lot of great unique things about the game, but the supermarket aspect with the trading and vending machines is not really what I want to play. That's not the game I want to play. And I think a lot of players, you know, have quit the game for the same reasons. They're kind of over the supermarket thing and the dupers and the economy and prices being all whack. And so you might ask why I'm doing this series. And it's, you know, for the same reasons Jesse did. I think we've all lost what this game's about, like I said, and it's quickly turned into a supermarket game. Players are cheating their way to become the first 2 trillion coins. They're massively scamming players for coins. They're buying and selling duped items. And dupers are loving every minute of it. In fact, I know a lot of dupers will actually donate to, you know, content creators and such. So that is a big problem to me. And I don't really want to play that game. That's not the game I want to play. And I know that's not the game that all of you want to play. So this gives me something new to create content for, because I've really kind of paused on the price guides. I don't really do price guides lately because, again, prices don't really mean anything in the game right now, right? So do you want to join me in this challenge? If you do, awesome. Now, before I begin, please hit that like button and subscribe if you are new. So first thing, if you already have an account and want to be able to do this but don't want to lose all your items, the thing I would recommend is to move all those items to your alt. And I would actually highly recommend this. I don't want you to go like reset your island and reset your data. I don't want you to like lose all your money and your data just because you want to join me on this journey. Because what's going to happen is if they do a game update and you really want to check out that game update, you're going to have a lot of catching up to do. And this might be hard for you. So this might actually be hard for a lot of players going back to the start. And I don't want you getting discouraged and completely quitting just because you did this challenge. So what I would recommend is trade your items to an alt. And then what you can do if you don't have an alt, or if you don't have like multiple devices to be able to do this with. So like if you're on Windows, it's easy because you could just use the web client with the Windows client. And I've talked about how to do this. If you don't know how to do it, let me know in the comments and I'll explain it, or someone else can. But if you don't have 2 devices and you can't trade items to yourself, then what I'd recommend is find a friend that is trustworthy and let them hold onto your items for a bit, and maybe for a fee, so that way you can guarantee you're going to get your items back. So give them something for holding your items, or just tell them like after you're done, you know, you only want coins or something. But I would hate for you to lose all your items. So speaking of, I'm basically going to reset my island in a minute here. So I've already kind of, you know, you can see my island's been gutted. I'm going to leave some stuff here because I don't really care about it, because I don't really need a bunch of fireflies and all that kind of stuff. I'm going to go ahead and reset, and then big reset. And then I'm going to make sure all my gold and stuff is transferred over and all my items are transferred to an alt, because for game updates, I do need to have an island that I can actually show off updates for. So I'm going to basically, you know, move all this stuff to my alt so I can do updates on my alt. So here we go. I'm going to bring my alt on and get this moved over. All right, so I'm back in here. So I'm going to drop all my stuff into these chests and then give it to Cryron King. So I'm going to also put all my money in. There we go. There's all my coins. Buy coins. And I'm going to give all my industrial chests here. All right, then we're going to fill the rest of these chests real quick. All right, I'm pretty much set on all this. I don't really need any of this other stuff. I got a bunch of extra wood and stuff, so I don't really need any of this. So I'm gonna go and reset now. So I'm gonna head back to my island and we're gonna wipe it out. So here we go. Bye bye island, man. This is unfortunate, but how many times have I done this? I don't know how many times I've reset, but I've reset a lot. So let's go and reset this island. There it goes. There we go, it's gone. It's all gone, man. All right, so I'm coming back into the game and we're gonna start this off. So we're gonna kick it off. So basically I'm a brand new account, right? So I'm a brand new player and I can't earn another trophy, which is good. And I'm gonna go and dump all this stuff off my character real quick, just so I don't have any of it. So we're gonna dump all this stuff. I'm gonna use my macro for it. All right, here we go. Okay, thanks for the copper island already. Thanks for the island, I appreciate it. Can we go back? Thank you, thank you. So I think I could speed this up a little bit more if I wanted to. Let me try that. I'm gonna speed this up. There we go, that's better. So we gotta get through all these. All right, I'm just gonna take a wooden pickaxe. That's fair. Bye-bye, Cryiron King. You're out of here. All right, so we got to start grinding. Oh my gosh, that took forever. Okay, all those items took absolutely forever for me to do. So I don't have an axe. That's going to be a little slower because of that, but that's okay. Let's get these down and chopped. Let's get them. All right, so again, there's no trading involved here, so I'm not going to be trading anyone. So everything's going to be naturally acquired, and I could only make money off of the vendors, off of the merchants. It's the only way to make money now. So I'm going to go ahead and craft my wooden pickaxe inside tech. Got one unfairly. That way I've earned everything in this game. I want to earn everything in this game. So let's go. The flowers are going to be good. I don't really need any flowers because I don't really care about colored blocks right now. But what I need to do is I need to get a cross pretty soon. So let me get this out of here because I'm going to need to make some stuff as well. So we need some iron ore and some wood. Let me replant these trees. So one of the things that I loved about early days of Islands was just the fact that we like really cared about our crops and stuff. And that's kind of what I'm looking forward to doing again. That's the main thing I'm looking forward to is doing farms again, making money that way. The other way to make money is going to be obviously through parts and stuff. You can make 30,000 off each of those. And then you also have the scorp scales. The scales are actually a really great way to make coins as well. I think Ruby scale goes for what, like 1,000 or something like that. I'll have to double check. But again, the nice thing about all this is you don't really have to pay for much. So it's not all about coins. It's all about resources, right? It's all about what you grind for, because you only need coins for things that you need to buy from the merchants. Like everything can be self, you know, gathered and created. So you don't need to be a millionaire in this version of the game. You really don't. It's all about what you have and what you grind for. It's really nice. All right, I need a little bit of grass here. Cut a little bit more grass. Okay, let's get across. There we go. How do I have 200 coins already? How do I have 200 coins? I was zero coin. How did I get? Oh, I'm getting paid. I'm getting my paychecks. I was like, how did I have 200 coins? I've been getting paychecks. That's so funny. Imagine just AFK farming your paychecks. That'd be hilarious. Okay, so we definitely need the fruit. We're going to keep our fruit tree there. Hopefully, we'll get some more seeds pretty soon. I need a workbench. I need to get this workbench. Let's get that workbench made. All right, so did you notice that the wooden axe actually got moved too? So I gotta do this the hard way. I can't actually make another wooden axe because they moved it to the pond temporarily, I think. All right, I'm really close on that one. So ultimately, what I'm trying to go for as soon as I can is I need to build up to a smelter. The reason why I need a smelter is, well, to smelt things. I need steel and stuff. So the first thing we're going for is obviously a farm, because once I have a farm, I could pretty much build out from there. So I'm going to be getting a bunch of coins from onions. So I'm going to make an onion farm, and I'm also going to make a starfruit farm. But you can't go straight to starfruit because the totems are really expensive. But we also need a smelter as soon as we can, because we're going to need conveyor belts, and conveyor belts are a big pain to make right now. All right, we got a bunch of fish. Let's go and sell these. All right, let's go buy some more saplings. Actually, you know, I'm gonna get another one of those seeds. We go sell these. We just need a little bit more coins. Let's go sell that and get our next seed. All right, we got enough. Now we got another potato. Let's go back. Your potato. So the easy thing is just take out the block under the tree. It's just a little faster. I need to go farm some iron. So let's go farm some iron. And let me grab these just in case they give me another seed. They probably won't. Okay, we'll go sell these real quick. There we go. Enough to buy another sapling or two. So I'll buy two saplings. All right, perfect. So I'm going to go farm about, I'm going to do like 20 iron. It's 15. All right, we got enough. We got enough to go back. Let's go smelt this. Let's go plant these. There we go. All right, we're going to use wood for our fuel for a bit because I don't really feel like getting a coal totem. Now it's time to start saving some money, though. Let's get these. We need to save for a lot more crop. So I've got 33 wood. We're doing good. So I'll tell you, you know, if you think you're good at this game, this is the way to do it. Like a lot of people think they're good at the game and then they can't grind for their own stuff. They just know how to trade. And trading is not reflective of skill, you know, at least of the main game for grinding, because without someone else grinding for you, you wouldn't be rich. Makes sense? Like you aren't self-reliant. So how can you be good at a game if you can't survive on your own? So I definitely recommend doing this approach if you want to show that you're good at the game. And this definitely is not a casual approach. That's why we call it hardcore mode. This is not something that a casual player does. Like a casual player is going to go and set up vendings. They're going to buy and sell on their island, but they're not going to do this. Generally speaking, they will not do this. All right. So what we need to do here, we need to actually get up to a small furnace. So we need a little bit more iron. And then after this, we're going to go for the second workbench so that I can start making better stuff. Next workbench is going to cost just a little bit more stone and a bunch of iron. We're doing all right here. So we need a lot more iron. So we need that furnace stat. How much is the furnace going to cost? 5 more iron. Okay. We're doing pretty good here. Let's see. What else can I use? Is there anything I need? So I won't be using like jukeboxes and anything like that. Plus it's just decor. It doesn't really affect anyone else. Ooh, I could really use a sword though. So I got a sword now. Cool. Let's pick that up. Replant it. Oh, I got another seed. Dude, very nice. Let's check that furnace. 4 more iron. All right, let's go check the fruit. Fruit's good. Okay, let's go chop this tree down. We might not actually need more trees. I think this might be actually enough trees. We'll see. We'll see once we start using them to craft, though. I really don't want to buy another campfire, but it only costs 10. No, I'll wait. I'll wait for furnace. Okay. So next we got to do, I don't need a net because that's only for like decoration anyway. Because fireflies are only good for decoration and lighting. So it's not really worth getting a net early on. Small chest, not worth it. Ladder, not worth it. So none of this stuff's really worth it. What we're really going for is this. So we should probably start farming some more stone based on that. So you don't actually need to go to the mines to farm stone, obviously. You can just get it from your island. All right, how much more do we need? We got enough stone now. We need 2 more iron. I did not know you could make potatoes. You can actually bake potatoes? Hold on. Why did I not know this? How did I not know you could make a baked potato? I don't think I've ever tried it, to be honest. Wow. I just made a baked potato. Are you kidding me? That's one hot potato? Oh my gosh, that's so cool. How much are those worth? Hold on. I never knew about these, dude. Wow, I never cook stuff, that's why. So you can't really even sell them to this guy yet. Okay, so they're not really worth making yet. Probably because you can't sell them right now. But maybe in the future you could. It's an easy way to get some food though. All right, we just need one more here. There we go. So let's craft our furnace. We finally got a furnace so we can get rid of this little campfire here. It's not worth it. And we got a furnace here. We're gonna go and fuel it up and we're gonna make some iron. So now I gotta go farm a bunch of iron. All right, I'm gonna go get some iron. I'm gonna sell what I've got. All right, I just got a bunch of money. So I got 340. So I can't afford a totem yet, but we're basically gonna save up for that. I think we're gonna save up for an iron totem. But for now, what I should do is I should go buy some more seeds. Carrots are actually a really great way to do it too. Carrots, I think, are 500 a piece. All right, let's go buy another. We're just gonna buy another potato seed for consistency. All right, there we go. This is certainly a lot more work than before, that's for sure, but it gives me something to do finally in Islands. I was just getting so bored, and I know a lot of you are getting bored too, but this is so much fun again. I love doing Noob to Pro videos. Especially, this is the first time I've done a hardcore version of it. Okay, so the one thing I'm gonna have to do is we're gonna have to get a bunch of iron here. So we need 44 more iron and 5 more stone. I can get the stone taken care of now. Actually, what I'll do is I'll do the stone out there, but I need a lot more here. So let's farm about 40 total iron ore, and then we'll get maybe like 10 of these. Actually, I'll go 50 iron ore. All right, that should be plenty of stone. All right, we're in good shape here. We're gonna go back now that we have everything we need. We're gonna come back here. We're gonna cut down some trees. Let's get the furnace going. All right, let's go check these. Okay, we just need 35 more iron. Let's see if, can I make another furnace? Yep, that'll solve that. All right, so we're almost done with this workbench tier 2. I'm just waiting for these 3. We'll be done with that. And then I need to farm some coins. I need some coins. I need lots of coins. We might just farm some wood for a bit. Okay, let's go ahead and upgrade this. There we go. So now we're upgraded to a tier 2. Bye-bye, basic. And now we're working on our farm here. So I do need an anvil, but I can't see. There it goes. So I need 50 iron for the anvil. So I want to get an anvil pretty soon. All right, let me go check my farm. I got another berry seed. Yay, so 2 berry bushes now. All right, now I need to go. I really need the monies. So I'm going to go grind some slime balls after I sell to this guy real quick. Wow, I just got a lot. Nice. We're going to save that money, though. Let's head back. And we're going to go grind some slimes for the monies. Too bad I can't use a sword that's on my back. You know, I'm just kidding. Dude, I just got +2 slime balls for blue. How did that happen? How am I getting double? I don't think we used to get 2. Thought we only got 1 before. I guess we get 2 now? Wow, they really buffed that. So sometimes you do only get 1. Sometimes you get 2. That's interesting. So we're going to do this for probably about 10 minutes. And after about 10 minutes, I'm going to sell and see how much we made. All right, so this has only been about 5 minutes. And look how much slime I've gotten. 91. I've got 7 greens. I got 13 blues. Got a bunch of buffalo core keys. Granted, a lot of the items I used to be able to sell on my island, you know, for through vendings, I'm not going to make anything off of these. So they're kind of useless now. Which really changes how you grind. This style of gameplay really changes about, you know, it really changes how you set up your island and stuff, because you're not so much caring about things that you can sell and flip on your island. through a vending machine, you're thinking about things that are useful for you to be able to build with. It's a lot more fun. Hey, there's a pink. These guys are brutal. They're so much faster. Did I get a pink out of that? Oh, I just got a slime. Bummer. I was hoping I'd get a gear. All right, even though it hasn't been a full 10 minutes, I'm going to go ahead and return and sell what I got. Let's see what we get. All right, so I'm selling all my slimes. 565, nice. 525 for the blues. And we got one pink for 125, nice. So that brings me up to 1800. So I don't know what I can do with this. Let me see, totems. I don't think I can afford anything useful yet. So we need a lot. We need 4,000. So you know what I'm gonna do instead is instead of taking that approach, I'm just gonna go ahead and buy some more seeds to continue with this potato farm. So I'm gonna buy 5 potato seeds and then one more. And we're gonna replant these and farm some. And actually I need to reset because my character is about to die. Okay, there we go. Get our seeds back here. I got another potato too. Getting some luck on these potatoes. All right. It'd be cool if we got more berry seeds too. That'd be nice. Okay, so I haven't farmed any iron and I don't really want to yet because ultimately we're gonna need a lot more pink slimes, which I think my next video is gonna be me getting a smelter because I think that's the first thing I'm gonna go after really. After all this kind of basic stuff set up, I think we're gonna go after a smelter. So let's see what other items do I really need. So I would like to get an anvil. So we're gonna grind for an anvil. What else do we really need though? Like really, really need. I would say a sawmill. We don't need a stone cutter because we're not gonna make any stone bricks. We don't ever need a vending machine. And I think that's pretty much it though. We only really need that anvil. I could use some torches. But I don't have any coal. So torches, so I need to go out and get some coal and some iron. We need a ton of iron. I think we need 50 iron, right? So let's make a ton of it. And we'll get some coal for those torches. And then my next video is gonna be all about the smelter. And then after the smelter, we're gonna go for that steel farm because we can't make steel without iron. Okay, how much? Yeah, we have plenty of coal now. Let's get this iron up. We need about 50 iron, so this is gonna take a moment. All right, so we can make our anvil, so I'm gonna go and make that. So we finally got that. So the next piece for me is obviously gonna be making the smelter. Now we can't make the smelter until we do have the tier 3 workbench, which is gonna be a little bit of work. And I'm going to need, a sawmill. I don't actually need a sawmill for the smelter, I don't think, so we can go ahead and skip that. But we're definitely gonna need to make a workbench tier 3. 450 iron, oh my gosh. 450 iron for this thing. This is gonna take some work. So let's see, I also need a stone cutter. So yeah, that's gonna be fun. That's gonna be great. But it's already been a lot of fun. I've been having a ton of fun doing this already. I feel like I value the basic items again. It's really cool. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, hit that like button and smash the subscribe button if you're new. And I'd love to know if you are joining me on this journey as well. Put that in the comments if you are, so I can keep an eye on your progress. And I will see you all tomorrow. Peace.